Day 8. It's about 8 a.m. Heading out. I got about 6.7 miles, I think, down to the road where I can get hitching to Julian. A little low on water. I definitely got dehydrated yesterday. You're always a little dehydrated, but I mean, I got a little more than I should be. I can kind of feel it. Drank some water this morning again, and drank a lot last night, and then a liter left, and I'm gonna try and put two electrolyte packets in that. Get two of those in. Should be all right. I think they leave water sometimes. I read sometimes there's some water at the bottom, so I can make that. Oh, it's 10 after 10, about a mile away from the road that I can hitch into Julian from. Guy back there, he's from New Zealand here on the trail. That's who you heard talking earlier. Great guy, fascinating. So, as I was saying yesterday, I would have done things differently and stopped back before, but now, of course, today I'm very glad that I went to where I went. I'm almost to the road. Hadn't been much to see. Just after I came winding my way down that mountain from where I camped on top, then it's just been a couple miles just flat desert. See if we can get a hitch.
Supply first at the 2 foot adventures. The street can get the mom's. Go to mom's, get your pie. 2 foot
okay.
Here.
Okay.
For produce, I'd recommend the Julian Market and Deli.
Okay.
For sandwiches and stuff, right around the corner here is Fat Anthony's. For pizza and stuff, Julian Beer Company is behind those trees on the left.
Okay.
And
good Julian pie. That's pizza.
No, it's really past Julian pie.
Oh, okay.
Cajun is right here.
Okay.
2 foot adventures is.
Metropolis of Julian. Took about 5 minutes to get a ride. That third person that passed picked me up, and then we went down further the road and picked up two other people, and I recognized one. The other one I kind of know. So that's kind of fun. It's 10:54. Pizza's about 5 minutes away. They open in 6 minutes. It's going to work out. I've been hanging out all day. Ate all that pizza. That was a miracle. Saw a bunch of other hikers I knew. Hung around down there for like 3 hours. I'm gonna stay, like I said, at the American Legion, but you can't check in until like 4:30. It's free, so it's about ten after four. So I'm kind of headed that way now. I'm just kind of walking around, kind of scoping out breakfast more than anything. Maybe. Julian Hotel. I was rich. That's where I'll be staying. And breakfast is included.
Thank you.
Day 9. Leaving Julian, I am 4 pounds heavier, which is good. I'm also 40 pounds heavier, all the water I'm carrying. Gonna go a light day today. Between here and where I'm going, which is about 22 miles. Now I'm gonna head up here a little ways and see if I get a hitch back to the trail.
Everything works.
Yeah.
That was just it. So, trying to take pictures of this.
I got it. Yeah.
This nasty road that I just go back and forth and back and forth.
Quick hitch. Actually, the first person picked me up. I didn't even have my thumb out yet. Somebody stopped and knew where I was going. This is kind of like a, it's under the bridge. This is where they got picked up yesterday, but of course I was on top of the bridge. But this underneath part has like a little, couple little chairs, has a water cache. And it says the next water cache is at 91.2, which you already know. It's about 14 miles. I'm not gonna go that far today. I'm gonna go nice and easy. I've got a little over 4 liters with me. Should be good. And then when I get up in the morning, I'll have an easy walk of probably 5 miles to the water cache, because there's no water between here and 24 miles. So we're relying on people leaving water. And then I'll hit that water and stock up enough to get for the day. And tomorrow I'll have another easy day and only be about 4 miles or five from Ranchita, which is where I'll be. So I'm taking basically 2.5 days to move 23 miles on purpose, because that'll be a Sunday. That'll also be my birthday. So I'll have an easy day on my birthday. Just kind of hang out, goof around, and shower, wash clothes, regular hiker chores. Also, I'm planning it this way because yesterday and the day before were obviously very hot. It'll be kind of hot today, and it'll be not very hot tomorrow. So I'm going to take a bigger day tomorrow than today. I'm going to take a nice easy day. And then the day after on Sunday is going to be nice and cool, which is, I should be hiking more on that day, but it, whatever. That's the plan. You're all caught up. So boring. Here's the bridge I was under like 7 minutes ago. So we're going. It's going to be kind of one long climb today, just steady. But there's no wind and no big brush, it looks like, so I think this is a good sun umbrella time. That's about 11. Maybe 11:10. I am going only about 5 or 6 more miles. Like I said, nice and easy. Should be about 8 or 9 miles. Tomorrow will be 9 or 10. And then Sunday, 5 or 6. There's a lot of campsites where I'm going. All within a mile. Just try and find me a good sweet spot. It's hot, but not too hot. The sun is definitely intense. But that's the desert sun for you. The umbrella kind of works, and I'm in hands-free. I got it clipped in. It works well. It's just, you know, susceptible to wind, and the hands-free thing is it's a work in progress. Lunch, table for one. I took kind of too long of a break. I almost fell asleep in that spot. I actually heard somebody coming, and they kind of woke me up. And I've been there about 1 hour and 15 minutes. A young gal from somewhere I couldn't place, somewhere in Europe, not German, So I told her to take my spot. So she's taking a break there. Our first warning code. Maybe let us get a little closer. There he is. All right, buddy. Get out of here. It's about 10 after 3, maybe. This is the campsite. There's a few more down here. Like I said, I'll only be going like, I don't even know, like 8, maybe 9 miles. I don't know. Keep looking here a little bit. Maybe push up a little further. At the very least, I'm gonna find a shady spot and make some decisions. Unless I find a great campsite. Ooh, look at that one. This one's pretty good. I don't know. I might drop my pack here and then hike up a little bit and see. I stayed. Other people. They knew I was coming, so they came.
What?
Go to sleep. Let's go tell these other people to go to sleep. Set up pretty good?
Looking good over here.
All right, go to sleep. That looks nice. A good spot. I looked at this spot first, but it was super, super windy at the time, and I thought it's gonna die when the sun goes down. And yeah, cool.
What was your name again, dude?
Long Strides.